Last week, I shared with you how you can leverage your laziness, and I spoke on one of the concepts called structured procrastination. And in this video, I'm going to be elaborating on what structured procrastination is and give you 5 steps that you can do to ensure that you use and be more productive in your life. Let's get started. All of us at some point or the other procrastinate on things that we need to do. But what is it that you really do when you're procrastinating? It's not like you're giving everything up and just doing nothing. When we procrastinate, we tend to do one task, but we are putting off another task, which is probably too overwhelming to us right now. Structured procrastination means you don't waste your time. You are just doing one task instead of doing a more important task. John Perry is a professor of philosophy in Stanford University and the author of the book, The Art of Procrastination. He explains, structured procrastination is shaping the structure of our tasks so the order of importance deceives our minds. He says it's reprogramming on how you're procrastinating. So instead of doing marginal, meaningless tasks, you are doing marginal, meaningful tasks. So in a nutshell, it's about wasting your time productively. Confused? Let me explain this with a scenario. You have to send a proposal to this client that you've been wanting to work with. You got a chance, you got an opportunity to send him a proposal, and now this has become a huge task for you because now you want to be perfect in your proposal. You're thinking about the proposal and the deadline while you're doing other tasks, which means that this task of creating a proposal is very important to you. However, the task itself can overwhelm you. So while you're doing your other tasks, serving your other clients, you're constantly thinking about the big task that you have to do, and you keep putting this off because you want that proposal to be perfect. Now the deadline comes closer and you panic about it and ultimately finish making that proposal and even submit on time. The not so important tasks that you're doing while you're thinking about this big task are called as the marginal tasks. They may or may not need your 100% focus. So considering this scenario, how can you ensure that you put structured procrastination to work? Very simple. First, you understand what activities that you do when you procrastinate, tasks that you avoid, and tasks that you can do on an autopilot. Next, you get into the habit of making lists. Now, if you're already in a habit of making lists, then good for you. If you're not, then you can simply start by writing down every single thing that you want to do or you have to do in a monthly, weekly, and a daily format. Make sure that all your tasks, including all those marginal tasks, are in that list. For example, you need to file a few papers on your desk, or you have to file GST, or you have to pay your electricity bill. Doesn't matter. Every single thing that you do in a given day, write them down in this list. Now from this list, look at those which are overwhelming you, the ones that you are avoiding in the first place. Now start breaking these tasks into smaller marginal tasks. It's basically slicing and dicing your tasks so they don't look very big and they don't overwhelm you. Here's an example. To write a blog, I need to do the following. 1. Figure out the topic. 2. Decide what my message would be. 3. Decide who my audience is going to be. 4. Research for any expert opinions on this topic. 5. Write the actual blog. 6. Publish the blog. All these tasks require varying amounts of time and energy. Now start adding these smaller tasks into your weekly list in between your other commitments. Now these other commitments could be a lunch with your friend or that movie you want to watch. Yes, add your social commitments into this list as well. Why? Because when you procrastinate, you need several breathers in between so that you do not stress yourself. Canceling on social commitments and things that you love doing is actually detrimental to your productivity, said Dr. Perry. So include them, and as you keep doing these tasks, physically tick them off from your list. But in between, don't forget to listen to your brain. Your brain tells you when you're bored and exhausted. And when it does, you need to include a breather or more interesting tasks so that you can rewire your brain continuously. Now, I'm not telling you to flip from one task to the other without completing anything. No, that's not the intention at all. Once you start a task, ensure that you complete it before you're jumping on to a breather or even your social commitment. So there you go. I gave you 5 steps that you can do to use structured procrastination in your life. The first one is to become aware. The second is for you to make lists of all the tasks that you do. The third is to slice and dice the larger tasks. Four is for you to include breathers and social commitments into your list. And finally, the fifth one is to ensure that you listen to your brain. If you are in a habit of procrastination, I urge you to try these 5 steps and do let me know how that works for you. You can leave your feedback in the comment section below or reach out to me in any of the social media platforms that I'm in. All links are provided in the description below. Thank you so very much for watching. If you like this video and find it resourceful, do hit a like button, share it with your friends, and of course, do not forget to subscribe to my channel. Subscribe and also hit the bell button so you're notified every week when I post a new video. I hope you have a wonderful time. I'll see you next week. Bye.